this is where we grind our camshafts. So if you guys want to, you're more welcome to get in and take a closer look. We start with a billet that's so raw chassis. And depending on your engine size, it may need to be clearance right here to clear the rod. And then it goes from that, and then we grind it to this profile. We have many different cam setups, and then this is basically a cam right here. So this is what we put in the machine to create a cam profile. We got many different cam profiles. For example, this cabinet, these are all cam profiles right here. So all these are different styles of cams. We also offer custom cams. We can have it done on a different, some people, depending on race engine, want it done on a different load center. We also offer that. Over here, behind this gentleman, is where we, my dad, is where we service our lifters. So we bring in our lifters right here, you see down below, and then we'll do the final process right here. A lot of things, you know, we bring in, but the final touches is what we do our precision last touches on. So after we get the cam ground, then this is a parkerizing machine right here. So this adds an anti-wear property, that black oxide finish that you see produced on the cam. So this is what we call the cam room right here, guys. Over here in this room, you can get in there. You guys want to take a closer look at this? I'm going to walk with you. So this room right here, we do a couple different processes. This is where we do our reciprocating weight balance assemblies right here. So we start by balancing the crank, then we balance the flywheel. So we'll zero the crank, then we zero the flywheel, and then we'll zero the clutch. That's what we do here. And then over here, this is where we hone our rods. So this is rods being honed. You guys can get in here and take a closer look. So we bring things in, but we do the final touches, the precision parts, hands on right here. And then we do our disc brake kits right here, and then press our studs and build disc brake kits here also. All of our rods are end-to-end balanced before shipping. So we bring it in, hone it, ARP 2000 bolts, and then end-to-end balance it here in-house before it ships. So in here, meat and potatoes machine shop. This is where a lot of setup and assembly takes place. You never know what's going to be there the next day. We lay things out and produce the product. Right here is a welded fan. So if you have a high RPM engine, this typical fan might come apart. So what we do here is we'll TIG weld the fan and balance it so it can experience higher RPMs without coming apart. And then right here, we lay this out, we're making turbo tops. So when you have a carburetor or a throttle body that you're going to pressurize, this is where we're setting up this to manufacture and make this also. So this is where we pressurize to turbocharge carburetors or throttle bodies. Right here, we kind of have a setup going. And like I said, you never know what's going to be set up from day to day. But this is basically what's occurring here is a full flow. This is where you drill and tap the case. So if you have an outgoing pump, it goes out through the oil filter, through the oil cooler, and then returns back into the case. It's just a better way of going about it. There's a lot of ways to skin it, but we feel this is a better approach to it. And then Aaron right here is boring this set of cylinder heads. So a lot of different setups in here day to day. This is where it kind of gets laid out. This is CCing the cylinder head right here. So if you have it chambered, 62 CCs, this is where we physically pour the liquid to verify that this is going to be the correct CC chamber for your build, depending on your compression ratio, if you're going to go high compression, low compression. This is where you physically pour liquid to verify the CC of the chamber. All right, so this is that's doing a three-angle valve job on the cylinder head here. Depending on the cylinder head, if it has chamber work or if it's having a forward gun to it, it'll come, if it's just not being ported, it'll come from this part of the building and then come to here to have the valve seats installed and then have the three-angle valve job done to it. Basically, the way this works is we have this machine right here. So what we'll do is we freeze the seats in liquid nitrogen to shrink them, and then we will press the seat in with this machine right here. So freezing it and then pressing it, it locks in and it don't come back out. What's the temperature on the liquid nitrogen?
-270 degrees
right here, if any of you guys want to feel that. It's all right. It's a different kind of cool. It's got a dry feeling to it. So it freezes this seat, and then we physically press it in the cylinder head, so it's locked in, and it's not going to come.
You want to try that, Ellie?
All right, maybe next time. You're new to the machine shop. I understand. That happens. Other part of the building right here is where we, if you have port work or chamber work, we have a 3-axis CNC that we do our chambering on, and then over here we have a 5-axis CNC. So if it's not ported or anything like that, it'll come from that part in here. Here's where we're going to do porting or chambering. So I'll explain a little more about these machines. You guys come on in here. Here, this is a 5-axis. This is where we do our porting. Previous to 5-axis CNC machines, to do porting, you would have to take it to a guy. It would be a lengthy wait. You know, you can't mirror one exactly to the other, so it kind of levels the playing field to where price is dropped and it offers availability for anyone to have a ported cylinder head. And we offer several different styles of porting, from to increase torque, gas mileage, or increase horsepower. So this is our dyno room right here. This is where we build it, test it, run it, and you know, check everything out before it's shipped. So if you guys want to take a look, this is all our products, our carburetors, manifolds, A1 exhaust, valve covers. This is an every week occurrence here that the engines are built, ran, and shipped all over the world.
Controlling all this, the load. So to see our power that we make, we go to the graph, and the blue is engine torque, red is horsepower, green is RPM. We're actually reading air fuel ratio down here at the bottom. So this engine made 151.5 horsepower. Looks like at 5,850 RPMs, which is right about in here. So wanted to show everybody, this is SuperFlow 600 flow bench. This is where all our cylinder head design, our ports, it all starts right here. It's basically just a big vacuum cleaner. It sucks air through the intake port, and then we can reverse everything and we can flow air out the exhaust port to measure airflow out the exhaust exit velocity. And it reads in CFM, cubic feet per minute. And this head, I was trying some different things on it. I actually kind of went the wrong way and I decreased the airflow. But anyway, I'm gonna turn it on, and it's a little loud, but you'll see the CFM show up right here on the computer, And then I'm going to put this in the port. This is called a pitot tube, and this is how we measure port velocity or airspeed going through the port. And we use it, we move it around, or I move it around in the port to find where the air is moving the fastest, and that gives me a good idea of where to work on that port to improve the airflow. So I'm going to turn this on, and air velocity will be here. CFM or airflow will be here. So this head's flowing 100, this port's flowing 165, 166 CFM max. So a good rule of thumb is about 1 horsepower per CFM. So this port could sustain about 165 horsepower. On a really high compression motor, a more efficient engine, we can bump that up to probably 180. So I'm going to turn it back on. I'll show you how the airspeed changes inside the port depending on where I put this. Tell people is air always tries to, or it's at its fastest point when it's going around a turn. I told the first group that comes through here, if you've ever been on like a lazy river at a hotel, when you go around the turn, you're always going to go faster on the inside of the turn because it's quicker, and that air or the water wants to travel around the short, we call it the short side radius. Right here is the short side radius of a port. So we're going to build up our most port velocity through there, and that's typically where I will try to work on a port to get more airflow. So, in a nutshell, that's kind of how it works. Alrighty, guys, write this.